Can you, how much can you tell us, or how are you feeling? How are you coming?
I feel better. I just, you know, my leg is weak, and, you know, I don't think I could, if something happened, I don't think I could get out of the way.
Okay.
You know, hell, I fell down a snowbank the other day and couldn't get out of the snowbank. Some guy driving by in a car had to stop and help me up. So, I'm sort of a feeble old man right now. My wheelchair's right outside their room. I walked down with my wheelchair and they walked in here.
Has,
I don't know.
Has it been hard this season? I mean, I know it kind of came abruptly. At least it seemed for us it did. I think it was Indiana game where you're up in the press box.
Well, what had happened? I don't want to get into a thing on Norm. but when they cut my toe off, you know, like your toes, where the toe's gone, that wound didn't close. So we were wrapping it every day. And then as you walked on it, it would seep, and it didn't close, and didn't close, and didn't close. So we tried to get through the year and do something after the year. Well, after the Michigan State game, I went in the locker room, they took off my shoe, and then it was like full of blood. You know, where it had gone, and the doctor told me, he said, you're going to the hospital the next morning. Mm-hmm. So they took me in there, and then they sewed it all up again and everything, and put me in a cast, and put my ass in bed. He said, now you can't walk on it at all. Because when I was walking on it, the pressure wouldn't let the wound close.
Mm-hmm.
So now the wound is closed.
Mm-hmm.
But in doing so, my leg, I'm like an old man, you know, atrophied.
Mm-hmm.
So I limp around and all that kind of stuff.
Do you, the press box to down to the field, I know you've been on the field forever. I mean, at Iowa, I know, I don't know if any other part stopping your coaching career, you've been exclusively up in the press box. Is there a difference? Do you have a preference? I mean, obviously, I think you want to be on the field.
Yeah, it's warmer up there and you can eat.
go to the bathroom,
I'd rather,
too.
I'd rather be on the field. I'd rather be on the field, but, you know, people think you can't see anything from the field, but, hell, I watch practice every day from the field.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not like, you know, it's not like when you're on the field, you got your eyes closed.
Mm-hmm.
But you are away from the players a little bit, that kind of stuff.
Is that what you like kind of about it, is being there, that quick communication one-on-one
yeah, like
with the guys?
Yeah, I talk to the players, and, you know, when you're up in the press box, it's, you know, it's like you're watching a game from in the closet. You know, there's no noise, there's no anything up there. Might as well watch it on TV and turn the sound down.
Every year we kind of go through this, and you say, well, my wife, doggone it, she doesn't want me around the house and all. Do you still see yourself coaching again next year?
Yeah.
Has this made you think at all about maybe when it might be time to step aside?
I don't know. If I didn't think I could do it, I'd be the first guy to say, that's it. I don't want to do it if I don't really believe I can do it. That's not fair to the team, and that's not fair to the other coaches. And I don't want to try to do something that I know I can't do. When I think I can't do it, this Cowboy's heading the other way. You know, I'll be the first guy to say, that's it, guys, I'm done. You know, I don't want to be that guy that hangs on longer than he should hang on. Maybe I am already. I don't know.
How much is Nesbitt improved?